North Pole. You know where Santa lives? How much do you know about the North Pole? Where is the North Pole? Are there animals in the North Pole? What's the temperature? And is there any land? Well, let's start off where the North Pole is located. The North Pole is located way up top, on top of the world, in the Northern Hemisphere. It gets pretty cold in the North Pole. Actually, if you visit the North Pole, I suggest you bring one coat, maybe two coats, or three. Now, the North Pole gets to about negative 29 degrees. Brr, that is cold. And most of the water freezes over where everything is nothing but ice. That's pretty interesting considering the sun rises in about March and it stays up all the way up until September and then the sun sets. What a long day, but it still stays cold. Now, what kind of animals live in the North Pole? You have polar bears. You have seals. You have walruses. And many, many more animals such as birds, whales, and even Arctic foxes. Hope you have fun learning about the North Pole. Remember, learning is fun, knowledge is key.
Holiday word scramble. You have 5 seconds to try to unscramble each word. Ready? Go. Santa. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Walking in the winter wonderland. Here comes Santa Claus. Tree. Christmas. Presents. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in the winter wonderland. December. Last one. Snow. How'd you guys do?
Hey guys, today we're going to be making an accordion fold Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. So for this project, you're going to be needing a pair of scissors, some glue. I'm going to use a hot glue gun just because it dries fast and I'm impatient, but that's definitely overkill, so just use regular glue for this. It'll be fine. You're going to need a pom-pom in red or a button or a bead, or if you don't have anything like that, you can just draw it on his nose, and a couple of googly eyes for his eyes. If you don't have those, you can use a button, a bead, or just draw it on. And then you're going to need like a little piece of fuzz or a cotton ball for his little tail. And then, like, you know the back of notebooks, that flimsy piece of cardboard that's in the back of your notebook? Well, you're gonna need something like that. So that's what I have here. And on that, I have drawn the Rudolph template. So grab a ruler or straight edge, put it against the edge of your paper, and trace it. And then put that against the edge you just traced, and trace it again. And that way you'll have two of the same width strips. And then you're gonna wanna draw two little bubble letter U's. That's what they look like. So if you don't know how to do that, just take your pencil and draw a U, and then take your pencil and draw around that U to make a bubble letter. And then you're going to want two of those. So what I suggest doing is cutting the first one out and then tracing it and then cutting that out. And that way it'll be the same size. And then you're going to need just a circle. So find a circle shape that's a little bit bigger than this U shape that you made here because you want it to kind of sit on the shoulders and trace that. And I colored mine brown just to give it a little bit more interest when we put it all together instead of everything being this kind of cardboard color. And then you can always go back and color the whole thing if you want. And then I drew some antlers. And antlers just kind of look like, well, these antlers just kind of look like little cactuses, or little cartoon hands. So it's just basically a straight rod shape, and then two little nubs on the side. And then finally, you want to draw some ears. And these ears I drew just kind of look like almonds that are kind of cut off on the ends. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this out, and I'll be right back. All right, I cut out all my shapes, and now it's time to put everything together. So we're gonna start by making this 3D accordion fold. So you wanna take one end of your strip, put some glue on the end, and then make a big L. So just stick that other piece down and glue it right on top. And make sure that these two edges here kind of meet up, and these two edges here meet up. So you have a right angle, like that. All right? Now we're gonna take this bottom piece, and we're gonna fold it up and over the top piece. Just like that. And then you're gonna take the other side, and you're gonna do the same thing. And you're just gonna repeat that until you are out of length. Now you wanna take your glue, put a dab on the end here, and then fold that last piece up. And for some reason, I must have done a good job, because it's a little bit crooked, but I know you guys will do better. And that is a 3D accordion fold. So now let's put together his head, his face. So I cut my ears out, I'm gonna turn this over, and I'm gonna glue on the ears. So you wanna glue the ears on kind of, on the upper side of the head. And then you wanna glue on the antlers. The antlers are gonna go above the ear. I'm gonna start with the nose. Time to put it all together. So take your glue, add a dab to one edge of your accordion fold, and connect your bubble letter U to that, and center that on the middle of the bottom of your U. And then take your glue and add another dab to the other side of your accordion fold and add your other U and kind of align those together. You want those to meet up. Now take your head and add some glue to the back of your head and connect that to the shoulders. See how the U forms the legs? Now we're gonna take our tail and add that to the back U. And there's our reindeer. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this project. I hope you made this project, and I hope you're having a wonderful holiday. I'll see you next time.